Okay, what are we learning today? Cold-blooded? There are animals with frost breath and horns made of icicles? Calling BioFriend. BioFriend, hey, what can you tell me about ice animals and frost monsters?
Frost monsters? What are you talking about?
I'm researching cold-blooded animals.
No, Cosmo. Lizards, fish, frogs, and insects are all cold-blooded animals. This means that they have the same body temperature as their environment.
Are you cold-blooded?
No, I'm warm-blooded like all mammals and birds. We make our own body heat, and our body temperature stays the same all the time.
Oh, this gives me an idea for a simulation.
Let me guess. What if humans were cold-blooded?
Yes, yes! Run simulation! Feeling hungry? Humans use 75% of the energy they get from their food to maintain a body temperature of 98.6 degrees. If humans were cold-blooded, you wouldn't need to use all your food energy to stay warm. This means you wouldn't need to eat as much food. You'd save a lot of money on groceries. When humans become cold, they shiver or put on a sweater. This wouldn't work if you were cold-blooded. Cold-blooded animals don't shiver because shivering takes too much energy, and putting on a sweater wouldn't work either. Because cold-blooded animals don't make their own body heat, there is no body heat for the sweater to trap. Instead, as a cold-blooded human, the only way to get warm would be to go someplace warm. Forget about ice skating. Every winter will be a struggle. As the temperature drops, humans will start to feel sleepy and will move more slowly. The brains and muscles of cold-blooded animals work more slowly in the cold. If humans want to remain active and alert, your homes will need to be kept at much higher temperatures. A good heater will be a matter of life and death. If you need to go outside in the winter, you will need to wear a special heated snowsuit to keep your body toasty warm. Some cold-blooded animals go into torpor when winter approaches. Torpor is like sleep, except that every part of the body slows way down. During torpor, the heart beats slowly, the lungs almost stop breathing, and the body's temperature falls. If humans went into torpor, you would be asleep for over half the year. Warm-blooded humans can survive in extremely cold environments, but cold-blooded humans would not. Most cold-blooded animals live in warmer environments. Vacation time! But if everybody moved to the tropics, it would be too crowded. There wouldn't be enough food, water, and space for everyone to live comfortably. BioFriend, hey, did you like my simulation?
It was a disaster! I got cold and sleepy, and I couldn't leave the house without wearing a heated snowsuit.
Fascinating! Bye, BioFriend!
Bye, Cosmo!
Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here! Life would be very different if humans were cold-blooded instead of warm-blooded. You would need to spend more time lying in the sun trying to warm up your body. What if you could conduct an experiment to show this? Step 1. Find 2 pieces of black paper or 2 black t-shirts. Step 2. This experiment will work best on a warm and sunny day. Go outside and place 1 black piece of paper or t-shirt in the shade. Place the other black piece of paper or t-shirt in the sun. Step 3. Wait 30 minutes. Step 4. Using your hand, compare the temperature of the black paper or t-shirt in the shade with the one in the sun. Which is warmer? Can you figure out why it is warmer? If you were cold-blooded, where would you go to warm up? Happy experimenting, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!